This could be an operating coal mine anywhere in the world. In fact, it's a simulated underground mine in Mackay in regional Queensland. And it's here where the potential of drones to improve worker safety is on show.
The benefits that it provides for safety, productivity, data analysis has just opened up this whole world of opportunities. So the HoverMap is a mobile smart scanning unit, and it is a combination of autonomy and mapping. So what it does is it allows drones to be able to operate safely underground, and with collision avoidance exploration modes, it means that you can remove humans from the work front and be able to collect that data in a more safe and efficient manner.
Yeah, it is able to adapt to changes in the environment.
A couple of years ago, flying a drone in a GPS denied environment was just not even thought of. Usually we need GPS to fly a drone or in a stable manner anyway, and now to be actually bring it into these environments and use the technology that we've developed, it makes it really exciting.
So we try and use the right tool for the application every time. So if it is an environment where it might be difficult for a ground robot to access, then we use the drones. If it's vice versa, we can use a ground-based vehicle. So it all depends on the environment. So being able to be mounted on a drone or mounted on the backpack or mounted on a vehicle or on a tracked robot.
We can go down into a mine or into an environment and scan that environment, and then almost in real time get that data back and be able to make decisions from that data almost instantly.
Being able to quickly capture and process a 3D point cloud means that you can quickly visualize an unknown area, and that visualization can then be used in so many applications. Geology, geotechnical, surveying, even communications and education. There's a world of opportunity there.
So the great thing about the SLAM technology is that we are able to get lots of different kinds of data from it, and which allows us to pick up different objects in the environment, so like rock bolts or place in the wall or different kinds of things, and we're able to develop algorithms to actually automatically pick out those objects and then be able to compare them against the design of the mine and make sure that they've been installed correctly, for example, or if they haven't moved because of geotechnical issues. So it's really good to be able to compare against the safety design model and make sure that it's done correctly.
Well, I think everyone in industry knows that there's some really exciting things happening in the tech space, and particularly with autonomous technology. So it's actually being able to let people see what's happening, not just letting people read about what's happening. You know, I think over the coming years, we're very much going to see a whole range of different, very futuristic type jobs. And, you know, first and foremost, it's going to remove people from dangerous environments and dangerous situations, which for everyone, that's what we're all here to try and do.
So if someone sees deterioration for some reason or just something that's not right against the design of the mine, they're able to look at that data and actually make improvements to the mine or add extra structures to the mine to actually make it safer to people to be in that environment or just completely take people out of that environment in the first place. So it's really a preventative measure rather than a reactive measure.
And when you compare what you used to have to do to access a mine site, the health and safety requirements, the production downtime, we're really in a unique situation that we've got this great facility that hopefully people start coming not just from around Queensland, around Australia, but once COVID's under control from around the world to come and test and train in our environment.